Ooh, how's everybody doing tonight? Right. You know, it's weird because, like, you probably see me. I can't see anybody. Like, I can see shadows, but that's theater. But I just want to introduce myself. My name is Mr. Kingsley. I am the co-director of tonight's show. We want to welcome you a little piece of heaven. So welcome and thank you for being here. Give yourself a round of applause. I took notes because if I don't stick to a script, I'll be talking for 15 minutes about how proud I am of our crew. So I'm going to keep it short because you didn't pay to watch me. You paid to watch our amazing actors up here. But I just want to say, yeah, again, we're really excited you're here. I want to reiterate, we are really proud of our amazing students that are part of this show. We have 12 dedicated student actors that are here, and every single one of them, this is their first time performing on a stage, so they're all new actors. But we are so proud and impressed of the hard work they've done to make it to this moment. Yeah, I'm so happy that, you know, we're here tonight. We put a show that we really think you're gonna love, okay? I just wanna quickly acknowledge a few people before we start. I have an amazing team that really helped support this, so I really wanna thank my co-director, Mr. Swartz, my executive producer, Ms. Shapiro, and I would go on about all the names, I just don't have time, but it took a village to really put this show on tonight. I also want to let you know, if you looked at the program tonight, the playbill, we have our donors that came to support, that made donations for the show tonight. So we really want to give a shout out and a thank you to all of our donors that donated to make this show possible tonight. We really could not have done it without you. And I also want to give a huge shout out to Victoria Santiago. If you've not met her, she's at the concessions. Make sure you say hi to her at some point, stop by. She has ruthlessly helped on a volunteer basis behind the scenes to help our fundraising efforts to get to where we are today. So I really want to thank you, Victoria. We really appreciate you. Thank you so much. All right. So just a few logistics and then I'll be out of here. Tonight, we have our concession stand, so at this time, if you had chips, drinks, whatever you brought in, we just ask that you open it now, just so there's not a lot of noise interruption as the show goes, okay? If you need to exit, we have exits on the right and left, there's lots of doors, so you should be good there, okay? And then we ask that you please put your phones away, but I don't see anyone's phone, so that's already a good start. Basically, if you have your phone out, there's light, which can be very distracting for the actors. So we just ask that you put your phone away. No flash photography or video. We will provide pictures upon request, as well as a video recording of the production, okay? So last thing, and then I'll be finished. The show uses flashing lights in the second act. So if you're sensitive to flashing lights, we'd just like to provide this warning that this will be after intermission in the second act, and we will have a 15-minute intermission between the show. Thank you. I'd like to officially start A Little Piece of Heaven. Thank you so much for being here. We look forward to it.
Elizabeth? I'm home.
Elizabeth?
Elizabeth? Are you deaf, woman? I'm home. Make me set an alarm. Wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning, that is. Make me drive halfway across the county to run your errands for you. The least you could do is drag your old carcass out of bed by 8:30 and have a cup of coffee ready for the love of your life. Woman, the man of the house has arrived.
I made the cup of coffee. I'm still waiting for the love of my life to arrive.
Well, if you haven't found them by now, you might as well give up. You're not quite the catch you used to be, you know?
Still enough of a catch to keep you around after all these years.
That you are. That you are. Good morning.
And to you.
This is simple things in life. I'm a simple man.
True words have never been spoken. Did you find the place okay?
Of course. Why would I have any trouble finding the place? The man gave such detailed directions, after all. Go out east on Highway 12 until you come to a water tower. Turn right on the third road after that. Stay on that road until you cross two bridges and look for a wooden fence on your right. You'll see an old mobile home. Turn left there onto another dirt road. A little ways down, you'll see an iron gate back off the road a few ways. That's my place. Watch out for the dogs. Better honk before you get out.
Sounded pretty easy to me.
Easy? I had to drive an hour on Highway 12 before I saw anything remotely resembling a water tower. And do you know how many wooden fences and mobile homes there are on those back roads?
Quite a few, I would guess.
Well, you would guess right.
Well, you found it, didn't you?
Of course I found it. You think a man could give you an idea on how many miles you have to travel between points is all. Besides, I got a crick in my neck from looking off to the right all morning long.
Then look to the left, and maybe you could balance them out.
Don't start.
Maybe you could squirt a little oil on it like Dorothy did to
Don't.
The Heaven forbid you stress some muscle now and then.
For the last time, I'm not joining your water aerobics class down at the Y.
That would involve you in a swimming suit. I wouldn't want to put my friend to that torture.
Can you just feel the love in this room?
Shut up.
It just permeates the air.
You're a moron.
Well, you love me anyway.
That I do. That I do. Almost didn't make it in time. What? Don't touch those. Those are for the customers, but of course you know that.
I know that, and I didn't touch them.
It's too early in the morning.
Didn't touch them.
If you would get some exercise now and then.
Yes, sir, a poet's paradise. That's what we are.
Get more oxygen to the blood and the brain.
So, no bites on the unwanted?
Well, we did only put it up last night, Henry, so.
I know that.
Next time you want to try to change the subject, be a tad bit more original. Oh, and take the trash out. And take those records out with you.
Seriously?
Do I look like I'm joking?
No. You're really gonna make me crazy one day, you know?
Doesn't sound like much of a challenge to me. And hurry up, we're gonna be opening up soon.
Yeah, I got it.
Come on in, Judith. Morning, Judith.
Oh, sorry. Not much there today, Elizabeth. There's a couple of bills, catalogs, but there is a letter there from Tom Bailey, probably asking you to vote for him for mayor again, as if anybody else wants the job.
Thanks for the heads up, Judith. Make yourself at home.
Not a problem. I see you got the help wanted sign out again.
Yep.
Katie's moved on, has she?
She sure has.
You know, that girl sure did do a lot of growing up the last few years. Jim Thompson said she was nothing but trouble in junior high. That was her principal, you know.
I know.
That was... I feel like... Everybody says that she was a kid, but could have cared less about school. Then she comes to work for you, finds a couple of books about the ocean stuck in a box somewhere, and now she's winning science awards to become a marine biologist. Some career choice for a kid who lives about 1,000 miles from the nearest ocean.
She had to find her niche, that's all. She's a good girl. We're gonna miss her.
I suppose so. Any luck finding a replacement?
Not yet, but we did only put up the Hope Wanted sign last night.
Well, make sure you hire a man this time.
Of course.
And I mean a man, not a boy. I'm not as young as I used to be. I shouldn't. Oh, all right, just one.
You're welcome.
Wow, Elizabeth. These are good.
I know.
Are you sure you can't give me the recipe?
Now, Judith, you've asked me that same question 6 days a week for the last 10 years. And you know my answer's gonna stay the same.
I know, I know. Doesn't hurt to try, though.
No, it doesn't. But it wouldn't be a secret family recipe now, would it?
Sure, sure. Well, if you do hire someone, and he's of the right age, will you introduce me?
Of course.
He doesn't have to be exactly my age.
I know.
5-10 years difference is that big of a deal.
I know.
Gray hair is not a problem, bald even.
If it is a man and he's breathing, you'll be the first to know.
Oxygen takes are okay, as long as he can carry it around with him.
Ha, get to work, bye.
Have you opened yet, Lizzie? Who was that? Oh. Sorry, Judith. I didn't see you there. I was rushing, as usual. I need eyes on the side of my head. When I get in a hurry, I have tunnel vision.
What's the rush, Glory?
I wanted to talk to you before Jared gets here.
He's coming in for his morning cookie, isn't he?
Doesn't he always?
It would be a first.
Listen, Lizzie. Jared's birthday is next week.
Really? I don't know.
That's because he won't let me talk about him in polite company. It's his 50th.
50th? That man don't look 50.
That is exactly the right thing to say. In fact, when the time comes, please say exactly that same thing to him.
Okay.
He is having a cow about his birthday and he's driving me crazy. I told him if he doesn't stop his whining, we're going to spend the 2-week vacation we have coming up at my mother's. And you know how he feels about that. I mean, he doesn't even want me to throw him a party, but please.
Morning, Glory. I never get tired of saying that.
I would have never known.
The refuse has been disposed of, m'lady.
That better not bend them too far, or you won't be able to get back up, now would you?
You're right.
As usual.
So, Where's Jerry?
Oh, he's coming. Can we go upstairs to talk? I really don't want him to hear this.
What?
Okay. I'll talk. While I'm gone, I'm gonna go show Gloria some new dress patterns, open up the shop, and clean around, please. We'll be back.
Oh my gosh. Take out the trash. Turn the sign around. Open the shop? I don't know what this woman wants from me.
Where is Glory?
Well, I don't know, Jared. Sometimes glory can be fleeting. The path to glory can be, well, treacherous. And how do we really define glory?
Don't these jokes just ever get old?
Not now, not ever.
Good. Good. I need to talk to you man to man.
Man to man. Okay. Sounds serious.
Yeah, a little.
All right, why don't we go ahead?
Just a little.
Yeah.
Look. Look at me, Henry. Look at me, Henry.
What exactly am I looking for here?
Do I look old to you, Henry?
No.
Because I'm not old. I can't be old. Do you know how old I am, Henry?
I don't.
I'm 49 years old, Henry. 49 years old!
Jared.
Next week, I turn 50. 50! I can't be 50.
Happy birthday?
No, not yet. Not happy.
Okay, well, I'm not
quite... You're not understanding me, Henry. 50! I can't be 50. I've seen 50. I can't be 50.
Jared, something tells me that you're just overreacting just a little bit here.
We're obviously not communicating on a deeper level here. Man to man.
Man to man.
Yeah. 50! Next, I know people who are 50, Henry. They look old. I don't look like that. I do not look like that.
Jared, you're right. You do not look like that. At all.
You don't even know what I'm talking about. It all really started to hit me when Glory and I took a trip back to my hometown about a month ago. Do you remember that?
I do.
I haven't been there in years. I've told you that.
You did.
Exactly. When we were there, I saw people. People I went to high school with. It was like a nightmare, Henry. A really scary nightmare. Ow. They all got just old.
Well, it happens, Jared.
But they're my age, Henry. My age. You know me. I'm objective. I'm honest. I'm honest with myself, and honestly, I cannot be that old.
Jared,
You're right. You cannot be that old. Thank you. People just age differently, that's all. I mean, they have different clocks. I've heard that on Oprah, so I mean, it's got to be true. They might be 15 years, but 40 will age.
40?
That is not a positive affirmation.
Here.
I'm sorry.
Whatever. The point is, we all age differently.
That I can agree with.
I mean, look at you. I know you're over 50. I don't know how much, but how long have we known each other? 10 years?
About 10 years.
In all that time, it doesn't seem like you've aged at all. You know, you really don't look like you've aged at all these years.
Well, Jared, let's just say when you're around people on a daily basis, you just don't notice the change. It's gradual. You look the same to me too.
Really?
Really?
I'm getting old, Henry. I don't like getting old.
Okay, think about this. You have a wife who's, well, several years younger. She'll keep you young.
Yeah, I've heard that one before.
It's true.
It's bull. She keeps me all this time about exercising, eating right. It's killing me.
That I can relate to.
Makes me feel even older when she does that. I can see in her what I used to be.
Jared, for the last time, you're not old!
50!
It's just a state of mind.
50!
You're as young as you feel!
Ben, tell that to my lower back!
You're as young as you feel!
There's no difference!
You know what? Sick of that. Have a cookie.
Thanks.
The sign says you're open.
Oh, right. Oh, I'm so sorry about that. What can I do for you?
Yeah, no, it's absolutely no problem. I don't mean to interrupt anything. Bike broke down. Mechanic dude across the street said I could hang out here while I wait for the verdict.
The verdict?
You know, the damages, how much it's going to cost. The verdict.
Well, you may absolutely hang out if you like.
Perfect. So, name is Kane. Michael Kane. Not the actor.
I'm Henry. I'm the King.
So I'll just take a look around, that's all right?
Well, please do. We have some really interesting items in the shop here.
Uh-huh.
You never know. You might find something meaningful.
Okay.
Yeah, just make yourself at home. If you have any questions, just let me know.
I do have a question about Gomer Pyle.
Gomer Pyle?
The mechanic? Sorry. Look, he told me his name, I just forgot, and he reminds me of Gomer Pyle. Anyways, he kept insisting that I ask you about some cookies? What the hell? Heck, what's that all about?
Oh, a cookie. Yep. Follow me. Ignore him. Cookies, they're famous around here. Have one.
Maybe later.
Cookies.
Who are you?
Excuse me?
Who are you?
Who are you?
Look at me,
Jared.
Do I have to?
Do I look old to you?
In relation to what?
What do you mean in relation to what?
Well, am I comparing you to a 4-week-old pup or a 40-year-old dog? Because, you know, if you were a 40-year-old dog, you'd be dead.
I'm not a dog.
Yeah, I can see that.
So, how do I compare the people you use?
Jared.
Well, are we talking 20-year-old people or 70-year-old people?
Both.
Jared, please.
Somewhere in between.
I like that. Answering a question without, well, answering a question.
The benefits of higher education.
So really, how old would you say I am?
Ignore him. He hasn't taken his medications yet.
Come on, take a shot.
Leave the boy alone.
I need a second opinion.
Okay. What's his name again?
Oh, Jared.
Jared. Let me take a shot in the dark here, and, you know, I'll guess that you're about to celebrate a birthday. And I'll guess, probably one of the big ones. Is it the big 6-0? It's just a joke, man. Relax.
6-0!
It's just a joke!
Jared. Calm down.
It is just a joke, man. Relax.
6-0?
Alright, why don't we start back here, you know?
Actually, is there a bank nearby? I'm short of cash, and I'll definitely need it. I need to restock this thing.
A bank? Oh, should be $2 down the right. Can't miss it.
Perfect. So, I'll just go grab a few bucks. If Golden Pile does appear, tell him I'll be back in a flash, right?
I will. Oh, one more thing. His name is Rupert, by the way.
Really?
The mechanic, yeah.
Even better. Good luck with that one.
Thanks. Would you not scare off the nice man? Please?
Nice? He said, I looked 60!
It was just a joke!
Thanks. I'm middle-aged.
Well, if you were to be middle-aged, you'd have to live to be 100, so.
I'm past middle age!
Another joke. Both jokes, I promise. So, you're turning 50. You should be grateful.
I know. I should. I should.
You should.
I'm not!
Yeah, I could definitely make this crazy.
Don't tell Glory we're talking about this. I told her not to tell anyone. If she knows I told you, she'll want to blab it all over town. No one else knows. No one.
My lips are sealed.
I can't.
Oh. Morning, Jared.
Oh, good. I'm good. How are you? I'm good.
What's going on here?
Not a thing. Not one thing, just a little guy talk. That's all. Just a couple of guys talking guy talk.
Guy talk.
Stuff guys talk about, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Sports.
Sports.
Fishing.
Fishing.
You know, interesting to
guys, bowling for girls,
bowling for girls.
Not interesting at all to you, ladies,
Nope.
Guy talk.
Guy talk.
Right, Henry?
Right.
Guy talk.
Guy talk.
So, you ready to go, honey? We should, probably get to work.
Seriously, Hart. Are you gonna eat that cookie or just squeeze some life out of it?
Not really hungry.
My cookie!
I'm sorry, Elizabeth.
Are you ill?
No.
Hart, me. Jared! You've eaten one of my homemade cookies for the last 10 years. You've never refused one of my cookies.
Just watching the waistline, you know? not getting younger, you know?
It's my cookie.
And they say marriage gets stale after a while. You are just full of surprises.
That's me, Mr. Surprising. We should probably get going.
Yeah. We'll talk more later. Bye, Henry.
And once more, we see that Laura can be here 1 minute and, well, gone the next.
But my cookie.
What about your cookie?
You take my cookie.
Well, that's how the cookie crumbles.
You're so funny.
What? We were just talking guy talk, that's all. You know, interest in the guys, going for girls.
Why are you running?
Sports, fishing. You know how I like my, baseball. All right, you do not have to know everything. A man has the right to keep man talk between men. It's a bond. A solemn bond. And on top of that, a man deserves a little bit of privacy now. In his own home. That's right. A man's home is his castle, and this castle owner's gates are closed. Closed and impenetrable.
You wish.
I was sworn to secrecy. A gentleman's agreement, if you will. I am a rock!
Good one.
All right, Jared's turning 50 next week and he's having a major middle age crisis about it and he doesn't want anyone to know. Are you satisfied?
No.
You know?
Of course I know. Gloria told me all about it.
What? Then why do we have to go through all that?
For fun, Avi.
For fun? Who do you think? You're back.
Yeah.
Are you married by chance? Never mind. Personal question. Don't mean to influence you one way or the other, but if you are, well, God bless you. If you aren't, you better sit down and have a chat with someone like me who's been married for, well, forever. And discuss it long and hard. There are things that men should know.
Like how long he's been married for. How can we help you? I beg your pardon?
Oh, Elizabeth, this is Michael Caine, the actor. And, he came in a little while earlier because, his motorcycle broke down. And, he was waiting to get an estimate from Rupert, and...
I'm afraid he hasn't come by yet.
We crossed paths on my way to the bank.
Good news?
He's going to have to order the parts, and it's going to cost me $1,000.
Oh.
Sorry. I'm broke. I'm actually broke.
You know, Rupert's a good guy. I'm sure you two can work something out. By the way, how short are you?
About $987 and what? 80 cents?
Oh. Well. I'm really sorry.
It happens.
You don't get it. But it's been 7 years. And I guess I should have kept track, but I never did.
Let's back it up. 7 years?
Long story.
Well, I'm sorry. Is there anything we can do?
Well, I don't suppose you want to hire a down on his luck biker. I haven't worked in 7 years, but I don't have much of a choice now.
Sorry. You'd like to work with us?
Yes, as I said. Look, I have worked for a living in the past. It just hasn't been necessary for a while.
Okay, Michael, what was it?
Kane! Not the actor. Yeah. Not the actor.
Thank you. I'm Elizabeth.
My wife. She thinks she's the queen.
Very, very nice to meet you, ma'am.
When could you start?
When could I start?
Am I not hearing myself? When could you start?
I could start right now.
Welcome.
What?
You said right now, so.
I did, but you guys don't even know me. Don't you want to interview me or something?
Well, you seem like a nice young man, and we could do the whole 20 questions thing later. But I have a feeling even if we do that, we still wouldn't know who you really are.
That's true.
Well, is there anything honest we should know about?
No. Well.
Then, we'll get to know each other through time. That's all anybody can really do.
That is true.
Well, Michael, pays $8.50 an hour if that doesn't, well, scare you off.
No, that's perfect. Thank you.
And I'm assuming since you just arrived in town, you don't have a place to stay?
No, not yet, ma'am.
Well, there's a room upstairs, no charge. It's yours if you like. We live here ourselves, you know?
No, I didn't know.
Yeah, the upstairs is our home.
Well, look, I really, really don't want to impose on you folks.
Look, it's really not a problem, son. It sure makes a commute to work short and sweet, and it also makes that $8.50 stretch a little bit more, too.
That's true. I'll take you up on that. Thank you.
You're also welcome to have meals with us if you would like.
I would.
That part you might want to think about.
Oh.
So, am I assuming you travel, Mike?
Yes, sir, I do. I'm just going to go grab my bags. It's right in my bike.
Oh, no. I'll get it. Oh, and I'll let Rupert know what's going on. Elizabeth here will show you to your room, and, well, let's see if any of us can actually get some work done today.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
Come on, Michael.
Elizabeth.
Would you like to try a cookie? And it's not a question.
I wouldn't do that if I were you. You'll never leave this town.
Henry, don't you have somewhere to go? You eat the cookie.
I warned you.
Holy cow!
It's too late now.
Come on. I know. I'm amazing. Question. Are you a good speller?
I think so.
Okay, great. We have some records in the back that need to be alphabetized. And Henry's excuse is that he's not a good speller.
Oh, what can I say? No, yes, I'm just calling to thank you for letting me keep the bike there until I can afford to get it fixed.
Hey, mister.
One second, little lady. And really, I swear, as soon as I have the money, I'll get it out of there, okay?
Mister.
One second, little lady. And I really...
Mister!
What the hell?
No. I said a bad word. Oh. You're not supposed to say a bad word. I'm just a sweet little kid. You don't say bad words in front of little kids.
I didn't say anything.
Yeah, right. Is that your bike I see over there across the street? It's a cool bike. Is that yours?
Rupert, there's a customer here. I'll call you back in a sec.
That's a 1985 Harley-Davidson Sportster XLX. That's cool.
What?
Chrome headers and a muffler and an iron engine.
Wow. How do you even know all of that?
I mean, how much is this?
I don't know.
Why not? You work here, don't you? If you don't know, who does? You're not very smart, are you?
Can you just stop being such a pain in the ass?
You did it again!
Will you stop bothering the nice man?
He's not nice. He almost said a bad word.
She kicked me!
Come on.
Wait! I just want to know how much this costs, that's all. Can you please find out how much this costs for me, sir?
You're good. She's good. Look at that. Doesn't even flinch. I'll bet she gives you fits.
Tell me about it.
Look, it's my first day here, young lady, but I will find how much this costs for you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Now come on.
Where do they keep the tag in these things?
What? Oh! You threw that again, and I swear I'll be right back.
Oh no, no way, I don't believe it, I don't believe this. What? How in the, Janet, come here, come look at this.
What?
Come look at what I found. This can't be what it looks like.
I think it is. Look, the initials, FT.
It's not. It's a coincidence. It can't be the same jacket. Let me see this.
Excuse me, is there anything I can help you with?
Do you know where you got this?
No.
How long have you had it?
I don't know. It's been with us for a few years. Quite some time now, actually.
Well, I'm sure it can't be. But this jacket looks identical to the one that my husband... Oh, I'm sorry. This is my husband, Frank. Frank Thomas. And I'm Janet. And those... Those are my children.
It's nice to meet you.
Anyways. He gave me this jacket when we started going steady. When we were in high school. when we first realized we were falling in love.
Mom, the children, in the room.
Unfortunately, less than 1 week after you gave it to me, it was locked. I won't go into details, but suffice it to say, it was not good. In fact, it's one of those things in a relationship that the significant other tends to bring up now. And again, even though it's been almost 15 years.
18 years.
Oh, 18 years.
3 months and 11 days.
Yes, 18 years, 3 months and 11 days.
I gave it to her the same day I watched it. I got it. Sorry. We had gone to the movies that night. A Richard Dreyfuss flick called Always.
Hey, I know that flick.
Frank, they don't need the details.
The movie had gone along with the theme for the evening. I gave it to her with a card that said, "For you, to keep, always, to always remember that I will always love you, always." I've always been quite the romantic.
Again, innocent, present.
Quite the literary genius, too.
Yeah, that's sweet.
Then, like she said, just a couple weeks later, it was gone.
And I've apologized a million times, Frank.
It's all right, sweetheart. You know I've never harbored any bad feelings about it.
That is not true. Every time we have a fight, it's the jacket. Every time you get mad, you remind me of the jacket. It's always the jacket.
I don't do that.
Yes, you do that all the time. Wait a minute, Frank. I don't want to tell if this is the jacket.
What?
It's always.
What?
You remember that night when we went home? On the back of the tag we wrote always, so we'd always remember everything about that night?
Oh, not.
Are you, like, permanently trying to scar your children?
Quit, I want to hear.
I'm almost afraid to look. Look, the initials FT.
That's impossible. It's not. It's not. How much?
Wait. There's no way this is the actual jacket.
It is. Look. This is incredible. After all these years. How much?
Elizabeth.
Hi. Oh. Sorry. Okay. First and first, you've already lost that jacket once. I would hate for you to buy it again.
I'll give you $100.
That's way too much.
50!
I don't know.
We insist.
Well, if you buy this doll with it that your daughter broke.
Hi. Yeah, you.
Then it's fine.
It's a deal.
Can we go now? They're usually not like this. Really.
They're in love.
Can you shut up?
You break it, you buy it.
Thank you so much. You will never know how much we appreciate this. I really mean it.
You're welcome. I'm just happy that it and you ended up in the same place, even though it did take 18 years.
3 months and 11 days.
Let's go. It's incredible. I still can't believe it.
Isn't it? I'll finally get to wear your letter jacket.
Ha! What do you mean you wear it? It's my jacket.
Which you gave to me.
Which you lost.
Oh, here it comes. Here we go again.
Here what comes? What do you mean, here we go again? You did lose it, didn't you? I'm not making that up, am I?
That was insane!
It was very nice.
Very nice? What are the chances they're gonna find any high school jacket here? Much less one they lost, what, 18 years ago?
You'd be surprised.
I'll be sure, Elizabeth. What you're trying to tell me right now is that in this conglomerate of
junk
stuff that you have lying around, people just walk in and find things they've lost for 2 decades?
Not all the time, Michael. No.
I was being sarcastic.
Not doing it well. Sometimes it's only 1 year. Sometimes it's only 5 years. Sometimes only 10. Sometimes actually only a month. It's hard to say.
Look, I know you're trying to pick on the new guy, but I know you can't be serious.
When you put this away, join me.
You just took it from...
That's not working. This shop, Michael, is a very special shop.
It's a nice little place.
It's more than that, Michael.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Maybe I better start from the beginning. Would that be okay?
Sure, I mean, look, unless God decides to work a little miracle on my Harley, I'll be stuck here for a while, so why not?
When I was a little girl, my mother gave me this necklace. Her mother had given it to her when she was very young. As far as monetary value, I'm sure it wasn't worth much. It was just a simple chain with a little butterfly on it that opened up, and inside was a picture of my great-grandmother when she was a child. I think she was around 12 years old when the picture was taken. The picture itself was actually a painting, a rendering of a photograph that had been taken of my great-grandmother. She, of course, had given it to my grandmother, so it was fairly heirloom. Are you with me?
Yeah. I mean, most families do have those heirlooms. My dad kept talking about this necklace that was going to be mine one day.
Exactly. When she told me the history behind it, it was really quite something. When my great-grandmother was a little girl, she visited Paris with her mother and father. Philippe Thomasson had just opened up his portrait studio that same year. The first photographic studio in the world, I believe. On that same day, they had a portrait done of her, and a French artist had painted a duplicate of that painting in that little heart, in that little locket.
Okay.
Her mother and father, of course, kept the photograph to hang in the family home, but they wanted their daughter to have a piece of that day to carry around with her. Mm-hmm. It was then handed down daughter to daughter to reach me. She told me all of these things in hopes that I would realize how much it meant to her in hopes that I would cherish it as much as she did. Well, I have a whole list of excuses. I was 8 years old for crying out loud. I was a tomboy. I liked climbing trees, playing baseball, wrestling.
And you lost.
I lost it. I have no idea how or when.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Not as sorry as I was. And the older I got, the sorrier I got. My mother was great about it, though. Never got mad at me, never blamed me. Sometimes I wish she had. Sometimes it hurts a lot worse when people you love just forgive you.
I can relate to that.
So I told you that to tell you this. A few years back, after Henry and I got married, I was a child, by the way. 20 years old is far too young to get married to a man nearly twice your age. Michael, if you have a daughter, you impress this upon her every chance you get. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. As I was saying, years back after Henry and I got married, we moved to this little hometown. It was about 200 or so miles away from my hometown. We needed a new sofa because... Oh my God, you do not want to know what the sofa that's been with a man, a single man, for 15 years looks or smells like. Anyway, we decided to stop by this little antique shop and...
By what's on your neck, the locker was there.
It was. And as far as I'm concerned, it was a gift from the heavens above. I decided right then and there that if I could, I wanted anybody to feel the same way that I could.
And Henry just went with it?
Him? No. But we gathered up the little things we got, gathered up as much stuff as we could, and within a few months, we were in business.
That's great. That's great for you, Elizabeth. I mean, I can't even imagine how finding that necklace must have felt for you. And look, I have to admit, I did see how happy Janet and Frank were for finding the jacket. At least, for that moment.
See? Skeptical.
What do you mean?
I believe that jacket will heal a very old wound between Janet and Frank, and their marriage will go much better, especially since we saw.
Whatever. The point is that something like that must have got to be like a million to one.
Seriously, Michael, in this time that we have owned this little shop, and there have been hundreds, if not thousands, like Janet and Frank, that found something that they desperately needed to find.
Thousands?
Thousands.
Okay. Look, why don't we change the subject? Where's Henry? Oh.
See, you spoke him into existence.
Gosh. Look who I found.
Lily! We were wondering when you would come.
I told Lily here about a new employee and, well, she wanted to meet him.
Well, I was doomed for a visit anyway.
Yeah, he's uncomfortably close.
Lily Adair, Michael Caine, not the actor. Michael Caine, Lily Adair. Lily's one of our oldest customers?
Oldest?
You know what I mean.
I'm afraid I do. You know, I'm a little bit hesitant to call myself a long-term customer necessarily, though, considering I've never quite bought anything. I feel as though long-term window shopper would be more appropriate. Pleased to, meet you, Mike.
Same here.
So what are you, like a hippie?
A something? Hippie.
Do they still call him that?
Who's them?
Wait, hold on, you got something in your face, son. Look like, hold on. Well, this one is handsome. He is a real looker. You are a real looker, son.
Thank you.
Has Judy seen this one yet?
Not yet.
Oh, you better watch out for them. That one is on. Permanent husband watch. If they still let you knock him in the back of the head and drag him by the comb, you'd be in some deep shit. You'd be in some deep trouble, son.
Well, Lily, I think it was the apen. The dragon.
Oh, now that is what they like you to think.
They?
Lily!
Oh, you know I'm telling the truth. Anyways, are you, married? What's up, son? Hello? I'm the senior citizen here. I'm the one who's supposed to be deaf. It's a simple question. I asked you, are you married?
Lily, just give this boy a little bit of privacy, would you?
Privacy? It's not like I'm asking for your social security information or anything. It's just a simple question.
All right, Lily, why don't you just go ahead and take a look around the store? You know, just stay far away from him, okay? You know, we really did get some new interesting items in this shop, and, well...
Aw, they're just trying to protect you from me. I mean, he's a fine young man. He looks intelligent and everything. I'm sure he can take care of himself. I mean, you can take care of yourself, right?
Huh? Yeah, I...
Perhaps not. Perhaps he's Lily,
I got your tea right here.
All right, fine, I'll go back to my shopping.
I promise you, she's a sweetheart. She's never going to be morally correct, that's all.
I hadn't noticed.
Michael.
Henry.
So, what do you think about holding down the fort for a little while?
Henry, you wouldn't want to leave him with Lily on his first day.
Look, it's no problem. I can handle it.
See? Not a problem. Oh, just don't listen to her. You'll be fine. Anyways, I ran across Glory when I was out, and she insists that we meet over at, Charlie's restaurant to plan for Jared's party. You remember Jared, right?
Cookie guy?
Yeah, cookie guy. Huh. He's turning 50 in a few days, and it's kind of a big deal.
Michael, it's getting late. We can close down the shop early.
Elizabeth, it's okay. I got it. He's got it.
Michael, she may talk her ear off. Actually, it's not me. She will talk her ear off. But just be patient with her. I promise.
She won't bite.
Okay.
Well, that's right. I've known this fine young man for about 10 years, and I haven't been him not once.
Not
yet.
Well, it's really getting late, so I doubt anyone else would even come in, right? If we're not back by then, just lock up. We've got a key.
Just be patient with her, I promise. Lily, if you need anything, anything at all, just tell Michael.
Oh, don't worry about it. I'll just go about my usual shopping and I'll be out in a jiffy.
Take care.
See ya. Are you sure I can't help you find anything?
I'm sorry, were you talking to me?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
You do not call me ma'am. You call me by my Christian name. I was given a name for a reason, you know.
Trying to be polite.
You may call me Miss Lily.
Miss Lily.
You know, after 87 years, I believe I have a right to insist on a few things. Being addressed by my proper name is one of them.
Try to keep that in mind.
You know, too many people in this world take a person's name for granted. For that matter, too many of them take their own names for granted.
Oh, yes.
You know, me and my husband, Jacob, put a great deal of thought into naming our first daughter, Rebecca. We put a great deal of thought into coming up with what we felt was the right name.
What was the name?
Rebecca.
Beautiful.
Beautiful listening skills you got there. You know, I imagine most parents do the same.
I imagine you're right.
You know, I do believe that most of us fit our names. I don't know how exactly to describe what I mean by that, but I do believe that most of us fit our names.
You think we fit?
Of course. I mean, could you imagine another name for Cory Grant?
His name was actually Archibald
Pratt. Or Boris Karloff.
Pratt. His name was Archibald.
See what I mean? Could you imagine, oh, Costello was Frankenstein? No. Boris Karloff. What a glorious name, and it fits just as Costello fits his.
I guess that's true, but,
you know, I do not judge, mind you, but I cannot abide by people who change their names to influence others in thinking they are something they are not.
Mm-hmm.
Nor can I abide by shortening the name for convenience's sake.
Shortening?
Hold on a second, sir. You were introduced to me as Michael.
Yes.
And you refer to yourself as Michael.
Uh-huh.
How many times in your life have you been referred to as Mike?
About a million, but really it doesn't...
See, that's my point! People have enough wiggle along suspicion in the first place and they have enough to give your name, your real name, the respect it deserves.
I guess you're right, Miss, Lily, but I really, really don't care that much.
Oh, well, clearly we all have our shortcomings.
Shortcomings? Just because you don't agree on something, it does not mean that it's a shortcoming. Oh my God. Are you not gonna shop?
What are you, like, married? Or...
I thought we discussed, what, 10 minutes ago, that I deserve some privacy.
Privacy? Now listen here, boy, I can think of a lot of situations where a person wants some privacy. When they're talking to their maker, when they hear nature's call, marriage is not one of them. Are you cheating on her?
No.
So we have established that you are married.
I didn't say that.
Divorced?
No.
Are you ashamed of your wife?
Absolutely not.
You know, in the world that I live in, marriages are not kept secret. If I could have, I would have climbed Mount Everest and broadcast my marriage to the entire world. I certainly let anyone in the range of my voice know I was pleased as pie to be hitched.
I'm so sure you would. I'm so sure. And I'm also sure that nobody will have any problem hearing you.
You just took a crack at me, didn't you?
No.
Future reference, it was a little bit weak.
When I take a crack at you, you know it.
Good. So far, this conversation has been less than invigorating. You know, it is one of the most joyous occasions we as human beings can experience, though. Marriage.
You're already back at that?
Listen, I don't know many of us who want to spend our entire lives alone, so when we find someone who we clearly, nearly, dearly hold close to our hearts, we should celebrate that, don't you agree?
Yes, I agree. But...
Some even go to great lengths, great expense, publish it in the newspapers for the whole world to see. Did you know that?
Yes! Yes, I knew that!
Well, clearly you and your wife didn't know that.
Oh, but we did. We put it everywhere. Journals and... Never mind!
And so?
Would you mind, for a second, telling me why is it that you believe you have the right to know these things about me?
Why don't you have a seat with me, Michael?
Why?
My dogs are barking!
What are you talking about?
My feet hurt! I'm an old woman! I got cords! I got a bunch of warts with you.
Oh, okay, fine, I'll sit.
Thank you, God, a gentleman for once. What was this about a gentleman?
Seriously.
Thank you, an actual gentleman.
Would you like a cup of water, perhaps some tea, or maybe some coffee? I mean, coffee machine is... Broke, you don't want me to try.
I don't need a gosh darn thing. Now come, sit. You know, Henry and Elizabeth are dear people to me, Michael. I've known them for 10 years, and they are very, very dear to me.
They are very nice.
They are. They're close friends. You know, I tend to look after my close friends. I've decided that you're probably not a bad guy.
I'm not. Look, as soon as I have the money, I'll get the heck out of this place.
I know that already. Henry told me.
So why all these questions?
Henry and Elizabeth are very trusted people. Now I, on the other hand, am...
Really? No kidding. No kidding.
You know, you seem like a very intelligent young man to me, Michael.
Thank you.
You don't seem like the type to suddenly run out of money.
I am a biker. I am traveling all the time, and I don't have a job.
You don't seem like that type either. You know, there must be more to you than meets the eye.
Really?
Yeah, look in your eye, Michael. I know it. I see it in the mirror every single morning.
And lie to me, Miss Lily.
I lost my husband 27 years ago. How long ago did you lose your wife?
This conversation is over.
Listen, I know it can be hard to talk.
You don't know anything.
And I know that people who refuse to stay in one place for very long are usually looking for something.
I am not looking for anything.
Whatever it is you're looking for will be easier to find with a little bit of help.
I don't need any help.
So if you ever want to talk.
I don't want to talk.
Fine. Far be it from me. Surprise.
Far be it for you. Every goddamn. Every goddamn. Doggone it, give me a second. Ah! There! So much better!
Having trouble expressing yourself?
No! I mean, yes! I mean, ever since I walked through the door, I haven't been able to... Let's say I've got used to a more colorful language over my years of life.
You mean you can't curse?
Yes, I can't curse.
Well, this place changes people, Michael.
Really? So why hasn't it changed you?
Pardon me?
Well, Elizabeth is saying that you've been coming to the store for the past 10 years. People walk in here and find things they've lost for decades, all the time. So why haven't you found it? What is it?
You know, that is a very good question. I mean, I've been looking for several years. I hardly
what is it, Miss Lily?
I mean, it's really small and...
What is it? I am so sure it'll be so much easier to find with a little bit of help.
Point. Take it. Anyways, shoot, you know it's getting kind of late. I should be getting home now. I have a family to feed.
Okay. You put me on the spot. I reacted badly. I apologize.
And I apologize for putting you on the spot, as you said.
Truce.
Truce.
I know you were only looking out for Harry and Elizabeth.
They are very, very dear to me.
If there's anything, you know, I can do to help, just come in and whatever.
You know, there is... one thing.
Actually, shoot!
I haven't had a man out of my place in years.
What are you talking about?
I'm not you getting any wrong ideas, son. I'm talking about work! Listen, boy, I must have a million little odd jobs I've been doing. I mean, there's a little hole in my neighbor's fence, and now comes through it a little dog. I mean, he yaps and yaps and yaps. Other little thing is, if he didn't have such a good heart, I would have actually put the darn thing down a long time ago, but because I can't, there's a little dog keeping up at night. And because there's a little dog keeping up at night, I can't sleep. And because I can't sleep, I got narcolepsy. And I can't even go down and fix the thing myself because of my old little brittle old lady bones. And because my husband's dead, I can't even have a man help me fix it myself. I just, Anyway, that fence needs men.
There's a fish. Huh? Oh, what? You want me to go and work at your place?
You said we needed money, didn't you?
I did.
Well, my money is as good as any. I'll see you Sunday after church.
Yes, ma'am. I mean, Miss Lily.
Now that's better. Oh, and don't you insult me by having lunch right after either.
Yes. Miss Lily.
Lily! Lily! You headed out?
So, what's the story? Is he terrified?
Oh, he was even worse than you when we first met. You would have thought he saw the Wicked Witch herself
into the room.
I love you, Henry. You're just so easy. Anyway, I'll see you Sunday.
So, what's this about Sunday?
Long story short, she wants me to go and work at her place. Something about fences and putting a dog down?
Well, that's great, other than putting the dog down, but, you know, I'm sure she hasn't had many visitors since, well, her husband passed, so she must have taken a liking to
you. I'll speak that about 2 or 3 times over, Harry.
Well, an invitation out to her place is quite the rare event, let me tell you.
So is the meeting over?
Meeting? Oh, no. My wife sent me back here to pick up my schedule for the next few days. It's about Jared's party. Sure you remember Jared. You know, I've had
Cookie
some
guy.
Honeydew missions to fit in for his party. It's really... Oh, here it is. You know, it's getting late. Why don't you go ahead and close up? Call it a day.
I mean, how do we do that?
You call it a day.
Close the shop.
Oh, you're right. It's your first day, and I didn't give you the keys. Well, let's go this quickly, huh? So first, lock up the register. That's this key right here. Next, the front door. This key right here. You can go ahead and lock that when I'm gone. Just, make sure you lock it. Mm-hmm. And as for the back door, you don't even have to worry about that. Me and Elizabeth have separate set of keys for them. What else? 2 light switches. One by the front door, one by the stairs. They both do the same thing, it just, well, depends on which way you're headed. Oh, and one more thing, just help yourself to anything you might like in the fridge. I'm gonna have to give you a full tour tomorrow morning. I'm really sorry we couldn't get around to doing that today.
There's no problem.
And Michael, don't be shy around here. Just make yourself at home. Well, I better get going now. Oh, one more thing. This whole shop might take a while getting used to, but, you know, I'm sure you'll manage. Oh, and when those 2 women get to scheming, it's a scary thing to watch.
Can only imagine.
You have a good evening.
You too, Henry. This was a shop of what? Enter Brave?
So long.
Be patient, Herb.
I passed Kitty Sullivan last time.
It's only been 5 minutes.
Didn't she say they'd be here in 5 minutes?
Yes.
Well, obviously, she was wrong.
What do you mean she was wrong? Why?
Because 5 minutes have passed, and I'm still sitting on this doggone floor, and it's dark.
Herb, you know when someone says 5 minutes, they need approximately 5 minutes?
Oh, what are they on? Greenwich Village time?
It's Greenwich Mean Time, Herb. And that has nothing to do with anything.
Well, thank you, Professor.
Dropout.
Princess.
Republican.
Wow, you got me there.
Feel the love. Just feel the love in this room.
Henry, stop that.
Yes, you two lovers be quiet. They'll be here any minute.
any minute. When I say 5 minutes, I mean 5 minutes.
Herb!
Fine. It better be here soon or someone's going to crow and drag me off this floor.
Get your cane off my leg.
Oh, so that's what it was. I know it felt old and leathery.
Oh, it takes one to know one. Now behave yourself.
And I hold on to something or I'll fall over.
Oh, you hush.
You may need a cider press to straighten me out again.
We all know that dementia has set in. You don't have to keep reminding us.
Quiet, I think I hear some footsteps outside. Yes, I see them. They're coming.
Jared, try the other one.
Rigor mortis is selling in here.
Quiet! Can't you see the key in the door?
How long have you been married to me, woman? You're lucky to still hear the nonsense that comes out of your mouth, much less a key in the door.
The joys of marriage.
Henry.
Where are they?
She said they'd be with Ellie
back.
Let me find a light.
Surprise! Happy birthday, Jerry!
Oh, wow, a surprise party. What a surprise. Shock almost.
It really is a shock.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I told you not to do this.
You know I never listen to you when I'm right.
Oh, you.
Oh. Happy birthday, sweetheart. Oh, I remember like it was yesterday.
Oh, please. You don't really put your teeth every night. We're not putting those things every morning. Saturday morning, beat me right now.
He was a week late, so I had a big bowl of spicy chili the night before. Shut him right up.
Mother.
Oh, 50 years old, I cannot believe my baby's turning 50 years old! I was telling Nancy, can you believe it, sweetheart?
No, I can't.
Oh, I was telling Nancy just the other day. You remember Nancy? Nancy Russell? You babysat when her parents were desperate that time. You remember?
I remember.
Oh, I was telling her I couldn't believe my baby was turning 50 years old. It is impossible.
No, it doesn't.
She's 43 herself now. Did you know that?
No, I didn't.
Oh, it looks terrible. Poor thing, but I hate to say it, but the years have not been good to her. I suppose it catches up with all of us.
Yeah, I suppose so. Thank you all so much. I really can't believe you did this. I really, really can't. Thank you.
Sam, I'd like you to meet the birthday boy. This is the birthday boy, Jared Havens. Jared, this is Sam Harvey. He works down at the public library. He just moved here from Minnesota.
Oh, good to meet you.
It gets cold in Minnesota.
I'll bet it does.
I don't care for the cold.
I'm sure it can be very harsh.
Harsh.
Don't talk to me, Ross. Isn't he wonderful?
Yeah, real conversationalist. Where are they?
Where's who?
Not who. What? I need a cookie.
Cookies? Oh, that's how you got here. You promised him some of those delicious cookies. It's a sickness, I tell you. He's a sick. sick man.
Now, Herb, he just likes a little cookie now and then.
Well, they weren't just any cookies. Every Christmas, Elizabeth makes up a batch of her special holiday recipe. I told him she made a batch especially for his birthday. It was only since today he'd even acknowledge it was his birthday.
It was true, wasn't it? You didn't just tell me that to get me over here, did you? Charlie's?
Yeah, we're all going over to dinner at Charlie's. That's where everyone else is waiting for us.
Everyone else?
Yes, everyone else. I decided that as psychotic as you've been acting these last couple of weeks, it'd be best to come to you in stages.
I'm not psychotic!
I didn't say you were psychotic, I said your behavior was psychotic.
Well, you just try turning 50 and see how you like it. I need a cookie.
Oh, sweetheart! Excuse us. I feel the need to share something with you, darling. I need you to know that first, I love you dearly. Secondly, the special event in your life has given me pause to reminisce, to remember all of the special moments we've had together these last couple of years. Third, and this is my most relevant point at the moment, you are this close to making me lose my mind! Never in my life have I heard so much sniveling coming from one human being. I'm turning 50. You and your legs turn 50. I'm going to be 50. So, here are the rules for this evening. You are going to march yourself down to Charlie's and have dinner with the overabundance of friends you have been blessed with in your life. You are going to listen to every joke they make about you being over the hill with diplomacy and grace. And by God, you are going to accept the AARP card. I am sure someone will hand to you. You're going to have so much fun, you're barely going to be able to stand yourself. And when this night is over with, you are going to come to terms with turning 50. Or you may not live to be 51. Are we clear? Dear.
Yes, dear. Yes.
You get him, girl.
Yeah! I love you, birthday boy.
Yes, dear.
And you love me too.
Yes, dear, I have a cookie now.
Let me get to Charlie's. Everybody ready?
It's about time. I'm an old man, and old men have to eat. Isn't that right, son?
Right, Dad.
Herb.
You can share some of the cookies with the rest of us. We can see what the big deal is there. Not gonna mean any.
You got cake right.
Yeah? Come along, kid.
You gonna come to Charlie's?
What?
Charlie's. The restaurant?
Oh, very well, Dad. I can just, you know, stay and tidy up.
Tidy up? I don't think we'd find anything. Besides, Miss Lily is going to be there, and, well, she never stays late. You know, I just think it could prove useful for someone to walk her home. Especially tonight.
Why especially tonight?
Oh, I don't know. It might rain.
Okay.
So you go?
Yes.
Great. Have you ever had a chance to get at Charlie since you came to town?
Not actually.
Oh, you're missing out. It has the best pot roast you'll ever eat. It melts in your mouth. Oh, don't tell Elizabeth I said that.
Why?
You know how some women are about their cooking. And I like her.
It's okay, Harry. Your secret is safe with me.
Thank you.
get home by myself?
I know what you said, but it's raining.
I can see that it's raining. I'm not blind. People think that just because you're old, you're blind. I am not blind.
Well, not completely.
I never said you were. Can I take that for you? It didn't even look cloudy when we went into Charlotte's.
Well, we get our share, trust me.
Yeah, sure you do. Anyways, you want a cup of coffee?
I think it commands a pot of coffee. I mean, they keep everything back there, don't they?
Yeah, they do.
I think I actually calculated once that percolated over 30,000 pounds of coffee money.
That's a lot of coffee.
Oh, math genius, are you? You know, I only know one way to make it so strong and true. That's what my old Jacob used to call it.
Well, I'm sure it'll be just fine.
Oh, well, see what your definition of fine is, you know. I remember he used to use the brew to take the rust off of things in the tool shed.
Okay.
You won't find this coffee at Starbucks. No, you won't. It'll take just a few minutes.
Sure. Well, do you mind if I ask you something, Miss Lily?
Sure, sure.
Are you feeling okay this evening?
Well, now that you say, back. And the arthritis in my shoulder is kicking like a mule. It does that most of the time, but especially when it rains. My back stiffened up on me about 7, 8 years ago. Haven't been able to quite stand up straight since then, and that's not a lot of blood.
Great, but really that's not what I was talking about.
I lost my real teeth about 20 years ago. Please, please think that is a trick. Especially since I can't see any real solid food these days.
Great, but again, that's not what I was talking about.
My hearing's going down the tubes, if you'll forgive the pun, and on a good day, commands to see clearly about 3, 4 feet in front of my face.
You know what?
My feet hurt. Sun up, sun down. I've got an ingrown on my left foot. It's all swollen and musty and crusty.
Oh my God, please stop.
Other than that, I feel like a girl of 15.
Great. That's great. That's not what I was talking about. How are you doing up here?
Well, now that is a different story. I mean, I'm not completely crazy yet, despite what some people think. I still got a few working brain cells up here.
Look, that's not what I was talking about either. And you know, let me just cut to the chase. Henry asked me to walk you home tonight.
Oh, did he then?
He did. Said that you need someone to walk you home tonight. Especially tonight, he said.
Why on earth would he say that?
Well, I don't know. Made me furious.
Well, you know what they say happens to the cat. Listen, I love that Henry as if you were my own son. Sometimes. He needs to learn to keep his trap shut and mind his own goddamn mind his own business.
Okay, so what you're telling me is that he should take after you.
Yes, that's exactly right. Wait. You just took another crack at me, didn't you?
I'm just saying.
Anyway, Tommy's finally ready.
I think you're trying to change the subject.
Change what subject?
Look. For starters, I'd like to know what it is that you've been coming after all these years.
Oh, I'm sure you would. Anyway, coffee is served in this kind of garbage.
Where's yours?
Huh? I don't drink the stuff.
But you said...
I said I made a lot of it. I never said I drank it. Now here, try it.
What?
Try it.
Fine. Yeah, that's... You weren't lying. That's strong and true. I think I like it.
Oh, of course you do.
Really, really do.
You are a better man than me.
Okay, look, I really think we should talk about
it. Talk about what now, son? You said you wanted Compton.
I didn't want Compton.
Then why'd you keep talking about it every time I walked into a room?
I thought you might want coffee.
What would make you think later?
It just seems that most people your age like coffee.
What is my age got to do with anything?
I don't know. I assumed you wanted coffee.
I don't drink the stuff.
Well, I know that. Now.
Now I like
tea. Unbelievable. Question, were you a politician in a past life? Have you always been that big-headed?
And have you always been so curious?
Me curious? You've been asking me questions non-stop since I walked through the door. You've been asking me questions, and you're probably at night Googling every single Michael Caine in existence.
I'm sorry, Googling?
The internet.
I have no use for it.
Perfect. Let's do it like this.
Do what like this?
I'll tell you something about me that you don't know. And in return, you tell me something about you that I don't know.
Why on earth would I do that?
Because maybe I want to know you. Maybe inside of there's a person I can coexist with. And I'm not such a bad guy either. Let me start. I never got to know any of my grandparents. One pair died when I was 4, and the other never really wanted to know. Not insinuating that you're old enough to be my grandparent.
Then you're blind, son! I'm close to being fossilized!
Okay, anyways, your turn.
Well, I grew up during the Depression.
Okay. Could have found that one out on my own in more ways than one.
I was around 8, 9 years old. I think like a lot of kids didn't realize just how bad it was. You see? He had grown up on a farm, so he didn't starve to death. Except there was no newspaper for us to read. No radio, no television, no internet. You know, thank heaven. A lot of people come to me and tell me how tough times must have been back then. And for all I know, I look back and I see a blessing.
Great. Did you grow up in this town? Friends? Neighbors?
Neighbors? We had a few, though they were very few and far between. Lived miles and miles apart, rarely ever got to really see each other. I believe that the word neighbor had a little different meaning for me.
And how did you and Arthur Gaker meet?
I'm afraid it's your turn.
Okay, fair. Well, as you mentioned before, I wasn't always a biker.
I could have figured that one out on my own too.
Smart aleck, aren't you? I was a very successful business attorney. Handled legal matters for large corporations and
and a lot of money.
And?
And I left. One day, I fixed my bike and left.
I don't remember just exactly how or when me and Jacob met. See, he was one of those closer neighbors. We grew up together. We only got to really see each other whenever our family got together, but it didn't take long for us to be fast friends. Over the years, we started to spend more and more time together. It wasn't until high school that we decided to call each other boyfriend and girlfriend. Look, I know this. Ever since I was a wee little girl, I knew that one day I would be Miss Lily Jacob and Air.
And how did that come about?
Under the greatest circumstances. Anyway, I should probably get some tea brewing for you, and I know you really don't want to drink that stuff.
No, it's... I think if I take another sip, my tonsils will melt.
You still have your tonsils?
I think so.
Them?
See?
Just give me a minute to get some water, boy.
Take your time. Good Lord, it's still raining. I'm pretty sure this is the first set of rain that I've seen ever since I got to this town.
Oh, we get our share, trust me.
I'm sure you do. Anyways, were you afraid?
Afraid?
Yeah, I mean, compared to now, those times were basically the Dark Ages.
Dark Ages?
You were so isolated from the rest of the world, that's what I mean. I mean, it must have been so dark at night, with all kinds of weird noises and animals and insects. Alright, Christian.
Listen here, boy, you are describing what many people would call a vacation. There's a good many folk who would pay a good sum of money to hear all of God's harmonies.
I'm a city boy.
Too bad for you, then. You sound like you need to be re-educated in the finer things in life. Anyway. Tea's ready. Be right back.
Speaking of tea, that's where I grew up. Boston. Went to Harvard Law. Met my wife. Anyways, he lived through both World War II and the Korean War. Was Jacob in the war?
Yes, those were the circumstances I was mentioning earlier.
Please, go on.
We had plans to be married in December of 1941, which we were, but Pearl Harbor and the war came before, so the morning after our marriage, he took a bus and headed off to war. You know, I don't regret it. I knew that we needed at least one moment call each other husband and wife, in case he didn't come back.
I can't even imagine how that must have been like.
It was hard for all of us. We saw each other rarely over the next few years.
You know, he was actually the driver of the Red Ball Express. Have you heard of that?
Yeah. Supply lines, right? It's a pretty, pretty dangerous job.
Actually served under General Pat.
How did you deal with that? I mean, knowing that the person you love most is just in harm's way every day.
Well, hey, a lot of prayers. I had to get through with nothing compared to what he had to do.
Well, you should be proud of him. He was a hero.
I was always proud of him because he always did what he believed was right. You know, you're not the first one to call him a hero for going over there, but he wouldn't have any of that. He said that not one sane man would come back from war thinking himself as a hero.
You push those boys onto that battlefield. By God, did they push! Farmers and businessmen and boys who weren't even old enough to leave home at the time picked up rifles and headed off to war. So, would it be the first time that God forgive us not be blessed?
Did he ever talk about his experience over there?
He would talk about boot camp, about his buddies. He would talk about the food and what the country was like. He went on and on and on about how beautiful Italy was, well, at least the parts that had been, well, destroyed. He said he always wanted to take me there someday because someday's caught up with us, but no, he never wanted to talk about the lightning, about the things he saw, and I, well,
well, I understand.
Anyway, we made it through. It wasn't until December of early 1944 that the war had finally ended. He came to me. He told me that he would never intend to miss another one of our anniversaries. From then on, he meant to make every single one from then on something special. And well, he did.
How?
Now that is something very, very personal.
And I'll guess that is my turn.
Indeed.
So, when I quit my job, I sold everything. House, cars, stuffed toys. I closed off my retirement plan. All the money in the bank. Grabbed my bike and took off. You know, 7 years. 7 years I've traveled all along these United States. And I didn't work. Didn't have to think about money until it ran out last week.
You've been traveling alone for 7 whole years?
Yeah, it's your turn.
I'm afraid that it's not enough, son.
What do you mean it's not enough?
As I said, it is very, very personal.
You gotta give me something.
Why exactly should I give
you? You gotta give me something. Go on, Miss Lily.
Well, maybe when you give me a little bit more.
Something!
Well, I know I'm gonna die.
What? I mean, don't get me wrong, but it's just nobody knows when they're going to die.
Few years after my Jacob passed, I had a heart attack. Everyone thought I was too far gone, mind you, but I was ready. I had lived a full life, mind you, but I was not ready. Unfinished business, mindset. So God came to me on my deathbed, and he told me that I would have 7 more years to roam. 7 more years.
7 more years. And, when are they gone?
That is between me and God.
I mean, that's great, Miss Lily. And I would like to believe you. I would, but...
Oh, but I was probably just delirious, right? An old woman under the influence of a lot of stress and medications. You know, what's funny is how so many people are willing to believe you when you say you're a follower of God. But as soon as someone says that God spoke to you, ain't nobody want to believe that.
That's not what I mean. That's not what I mean. just that it doesn't make any sense. It does not make any sense. Why would he do that? Didn't you tell me that? Why would he give you 7 more years? Give you 7 more years and take years. Years from...
From who?
Others. Years from others. Others were young. Young, healthy, and alive. Others like...
You mean... Others like your wife?
Yes! Others like my wife! Others like my wife. Why would he do that? She was coming back from a grocery store. A grocery store. A car ran a red light and blindsided her. She crashed and lived a few hours in the hospital. Maggie, that's her name.
Can't blame yourself for her death, Michael.
And I don't. I don't, okay? Accidents happen. I know that. I blame myself for not being. I was 500 miles away, close to striking a big business deal, and close to making a lot of money. And when I got there, she was gone.
Home? It was your job. She understood that.
I was the one who asked her to move to Boston. I was the one who asked her to move away from her friends. I was the one who asked her to move away from her family. I was the only one she had, and I let her die alone.
She didn't die alone, Michael. No one ever dies alone. Listen, if God could come to an old, begrudging woman like you, know he was there for her. You know he was.
You really think so?
I do. And she loved you, Michael. She would have carried you with her in her mind. In her heart. Listen, I lost my husband 27 years ago, but he is still here, as much as he ever was. So you see, she didn't die alone, Michael. You were with her, the most important part of you. Your God was with her then.
You have all the answers, don't you?
As far as I'm concerned, that is the absolute truth.
You know, I wish I knew why things happen the way that they do. But maybe I don't. But what I do know is this. I do believe that there is a reason behind.
Well, now you know what I've been carrying for 7 years. But you've been carrying something for even longer.
My Jacob was not a dancer. He didn't make any bones about it. He let me know that from the start. Now I, on the other hand, love to dance. I'm pretty sure I learned how to dance before I even learned how to walk. Some of the most blessed moments of my childhood were spent dancing. Now Daddy was a farmer, so he could toss out a big bale of hay with the best of them. But when he stepped on that dance floor, Ginger Rogers couldn't have had a better partner. The night of our fifth wedding anniversary, after dinner,
Jacob decided to take me to the living room table. It was a brand new phonograph. That in itself was quite something. You see, we had very little money for luxuries back then, and that was certainly a luxury for us. And in it was a brand new record. A brand new recording by Al Jolson, one of my all-time favorites. In it was his new hit record, Dream a Little Dream of Me. When I closed my eyes, I can see him standing right there as if it were just yesterday. Handsome as ever, he walked over to me and he asked me if I could have this dance. Now mind you, I'd never danced with him before, and God, what a dance! I will never forget that dance.
Wait, Dream a Little Dream with me?
Every single year, on our anniversary, we dance that same dance to that same song. It was the only time we ever danced. Hell, there's certain points, the only time we ever really even saw each other. Whether it be for the good moments, the bad moments, or the most dark, disparaging moments of our lives, we always had our dance.
Dream a little dream of me. Dream a little dream of me. That's it.
What?
That's it, isn't it? That's it. Look, the first thing Elizabeth asked me to do was to organize some records, and I did, but Harry brought in a box yesterday, and I can swear I stay right there. You stay right there. Wait a sec. Dream a little dream of me. This is it.
After Jacob passed away, I figured it would be a good idea to donate some of his things to the church. Every single year, they hold a big garage sale, and I thought someone else could make better use of his things than he could. The only way I could think of they could have gotten lost. You know, a friend of mine helped me pack up, and she must have gotten mixed up with all the other junk. The only way I could think of they could have possibly gotten lost. It's been so long.
Oh, do you want me to play it for you?
I don't know. Can you?
Well, you did see the phonograph. I am pretty sure it works.
But I'm not so sure if it's a good idea. I mean, I don't want to act like a blithering idiot in front of you, but oh God, it's been so long. Can you?
I can. I will.
Don't you dare.
I swear I won't. Now, excuse me if this takes a while, but this is not for my time.
We were married on Christmas Eve.
I didn't.
The morning after our marriage, he ordered a bus and headed off to war.
Yeah.
57 years I was married to that man, and it was no picnic, let me tell you. That man was the most stubborn man God ever saw fit to breathe on this earth. He was the most contrary, most irritating, most wonderful man, and I miss him so.
Well, miss, I learned how to dance before I learned how to walk. Maybe you still have a step or two in those old legs.
Oh, you good. Still
craving your kiss. How you crave my kiss. Now I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear. Just saying this.
Give me a little kiss.
Sweet dreams. Till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be,
that wasn't that bad.
Dream a little dream.
Oh, how of me.
Miss Lily? Miss Lily, are you okay?
I'm fine, if you just help me sit down.
Of course.
Oh, Jesus.
Are you okay? Do you need a cup of water?
Record, Michael, bring me the record, please.
Yeah, but you don't look okay. Maybe I should call a doctor.
I don't need a doctor, Michael. I need the record, please.
Okay, fine, but after that, I'm calling a doctor. Okay, now I am calling a doctor.
No, my purse. Bring me my purse, please.
Your purse? Yes. Pills. Yes, okay. Do you have any pills that you need to take? I can grab some water.
Wait. I want you to take this for the record.
What?
I need to pay for it again, then I'll be mine. I hope it's enough.
I hope? Of course it's enough. I doubt Elizabeth and Henry will even make you pay for it. I thought you were looking for pills.
I don't have any pills. Don't take this.
I am calling a doctor.
I don't need a doctor. I don't want a doctor. I'm taking my...
How do you feel?
I feel wonderful. I feel more alive than I have in years. Seems you've been on a dance floor more than once or twice in your life.
And you cut quite the rug for a woman your...
Oh, don't you dare say a woman my age. I may be old, but I could still dance. Great.
I believe it. I do believe it.
You should keep on practicing that. You know?
Don't worry about that.
Maybe this one.
What?
It's mine. And I can do what I want with it, and I want you to have it. I'll take it before I decide to break it over that thick skull of yours.
You just bought it!
I need you to take it. I need you to carry on with its lineage.
Thank you.
It was 7 whole years ago. Tonight.
What?
7 whole years. I'm so
glad that you were here for me.
Miss Lily. Miss Lily! Miss Lily! I mean, Judith, I thought you were Henry or Elizabeth coming in.
No, they're not here.
No, I haven't seen them since yesterday afternoon. I mean, I woke up and there was no one here. There aren't any cookies out yet.
No cookies? Something.
I'm starting to feel worried. Maybe. It's just weird that they didn't even leave a message. Oh, I do hope so.
Beautiful funeral yesterday, wasn't it?
It was.
She went out in style.
That she did.
Mill?
Thank you. You always come in there. I am not Elmo Big Bird.
Oh, sorry.
No worries. This is weird. They're all labeled as a little piece of heaven. Shouldn't some of them have, what, Harry or Elizabeth's names in them?
They always come like that.
And you don't think it's weird?
Not really. I guess I never really thought about it.
I mean, now that I think of it, I don't even know their last names. That's insane. Do you know their last names?
Well, of course I do. I've only known them for like 10 years. It's... Boy, I'm having a brain dead moment. That's probably it. You know what? It'll come to me later.
Sure, I'll guess I'll just ask when I see them.
Sure. Did you get to meet Sam the other night?
Yes. Oh, yes, I did.
I think he may be the one. He has such a dynamic personality, don't you think?
Really? Don't know him well enough to tell.
Well, you have to get to know him more. I insist.
Yes, I would love to.
If you think the conversation the other night was great, just wait.
Can't wait.
Darn. You have to tell me the rest later.
Sure. I mean, there wasn't much conversation between us, but have a nice word.
I almost forgot.
What?
I've been meaning to ask Elizabeth something.
Huh.
I've been so long admiring the little locket that Elizabeth wears. Tomorrow's my little niece Cindy's birthday, and I've been wanting to get her something like that. Do you know where she got it?
Well, Ashley, I do. She told me the very, very, very long story behind it.
Story?
Don't you have to work?
I have time.
Anyways, the locket was given to her great-grandmother. Grandmother, I'm sorry. And was it grandmother? Okay, yes, was grandmother. It was given to her grandmother, I'm very sure, when she was a child. 11, 12, a kid, around that age. Families went to Paris. Photographic studio, one of the first photographic studios, opened in the year that same first photographic studio was ever opened. A guy by the name of Felix Dumachon, something like that, got the picture done. And after that, they had a local artist do a rendering of that and put in the locket.
You said Felix Dumachon?
I'm pretty sure that's right. I mean, I never remember Bob or Dave, but the weird names always stick with me.
Well, that can't be right.
What?
Well, when I'm not performing my usual duties, I'm quite the enthusiast of the fine art of photography. I even took a course over at the junior college.
And?
That means that Felix Dumachon did open the first photography studio in Paris. But that was in 1851. Even if we assume that Elizabeth's grandmother and mother were born in their late 20s to early 30s, which probably isn't right, women usually had their kids at much younger times. That would mean that Elizabeth was born at the turn of the century, the early 1900s. She cannot be that old. I do not think she's that old.
No, I really... really don't think she's that old.
Maybe she met her great-great-great-grandmother.
Maybe, or maybe I heard it wrong.
Oh, bummer. You're gonna have to tell me the rest later. I have some things I need to do.
Sure thing, Judith. Oh. Let me get that for you.
Tell Henry and Elizabeth I said hi. I'll drop back in later to check on those cookies.
See you. Henry, Elizabeth, finally, I thought something happened to you guys.
Nothing happened to us, Michael. We do need to talk to you, though.
I need to talk to you.
All right. You're first.
Sure. So, I know that when I first got the job, I said that I probably wouldn't be here for long. However, I've been taking quite the liking of this place. So I was wondering if maybe you
before
guys
I said anything else, would like for you to sit down.
All right.
Look, Michael, we are so glad you were here the other night for Miss Lily.
What did the doctor say? Was it a heart attack?
He didn't say. It was just her time.
You knew it. You knew it! Didn't you? That's why you asked me to walk her home that night.
Look, we only knew what she believed. She had told us what happened in the hospital that night, after all.
And you really think she talked to God?
Let's just say we have absolutely no reason to believe that it couldn't happen.
Look, don't feel bad, Mike. Lily was a woman who loved life, but she wasn't afraid to die.
that she wasn't.
So, it was an old Al Jolson record, huh? You know, she never told us.
Ella Fitzgerald.
Ella Fitzgerald.
Dream a little dream of me. But she never told you?
Not a word in 10 years. She must have really trusted you.
We did get to know each other pretty well.
Michael, we knew you were here for a reason. From the first moment you walked in the door. It just wasn't the reason you thought it was.
What are you talking about?
I told you that we felt this place was our calling. It was what we needed to do. We believe very strongly that every person that walks through that door has a need to fill. The things in this store can answer a prayer, sometimes many prayers.
And we also believe that there are people all over who need answers to those prayers. So, about every 10 years or so, we try to find someone who feels the same way we do. In this case, being you.
The things in this store can save a marriage. They can complete a life. They could provide an answer. It always answers a prayer, Michael. Do you believe that?
I do.
Then now you know why you're here. If you accept, the store is yours.
Mine.
Yours.
Just like that, mine.
Yours, just like that. We still have work to do, more people like you to find, and more stores to open before we move on.
Move on?
Oh, you know, places to go, people to see, that sort of thing.
You said you do this every 10 years.
That usually seems to be enough, yeah.
You're not nearly old enough to have done that.
Oh, before we go, we're gonna stop by Charlie's. Henry over here loves the blueberry pancakes.
Oh, I've gotta have them one more time. You never know what the food will be like where we're going, so.
We'd love to invite you, but we got a call from Miss Lily's daughter saying something about someone's coming over to get a key and we thought you could wait for them.
But how are you going?
Don't worry. Today's Thursday. On Monday morning, our man will come by with all the necessary papers. And we've already signed everything, so you don't have to worry about that. We'll leave the keys with you on our way out. And we also travel pretty light, so pretty much everything
will
be here.
Where will you go?
Oh, we'll get pointed in the right direction.
What? What? From what he told me, and he did this every 10 years, and you look to be what, 50? 60? This doesn't make any sense. Wait!
Don't want them to run out of those fresh blueberries.
Wait a second! Henry, wait a second! You have some questions to answer!
I don't. I don't know you, so I don't think I'll be answering any of your questions.
I wasn't talking to you.
Really? I don't see anyone else here.
They were just... Never mind. How can I help?
Are you the owner?
I guess I am.
You get.
New owner. Haven't gotten used to it yet.
My name is Billy St. John. I was told to ask the owner for a key to Lilia Deer's home. She was my grandmother.
Kane. Michael Kane, your grandmother?
Yes.
Miss Lily was your grandmother.
That twice you've gotten it right, yes.
Your grandmother?
Can I have that back? My hand.
Sorry, I mean, you just... Wow, I mean, your grandmother.
Your power of observation is so underwhelming. Now, can we move on?
Oh, yes, I Apologize. I see the resemblance in more ways than one, trust me.
You knew her?
Yes, I was with her when she passed.
Oh, well, I have many questions for you then.
Also runs in the family. Anyways.
Me?
Never mind. Look, there's this place down the street that's selling some blueberry pancakes. And, you know, I can buy you some coffee.
It's really not necessary. You see, I'll be living here in town. I've decided to move into my grandmother's home.
Really?
Do you always do that?
What?
Ask for verification of things people have just told you.
No.
Good. It tends to be old.
Okay, anyways, blueberry pancakes? Coffee?
Don't drink the stuff.
Figured. Tea.
Yes, but it's really not necessary.
Great dancer?
What?
Never mind, I'll save the questions for later. So I insist.
Okay, if you agree.
Yes, I do. There's no way.
Still craving your kiss.